I am worried about Spider-Man 3, but probably not for the reasons you think, so let me explain. So far, we know that the Morbius movie will be connected to the MCU because of the Vulture, and connected to the Raimiverse because of some leaked set photos. And recently, it was revealed that Jamie Foxx will be playing Electro in Tom Holland's Spider-Man 3. Although it doesn't appear to be the same Electro he played in The Amazing Spider-Man 2, but still, it's very odd that they'd rehire the same actor to play the same character. And now, there are a lot of rumors going around that Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield have been casted. Basically, everything we've heard about this film so far points to it being a live-action Spider-Verse film, and I don't want that. Don't get me wrong, I'd love to have a live-action Spider-Verse movie. Eventually. Now is not the time. The MCU may be heading in the multiverse direction with Doctor Strange and WandaVision, but let's revisit how Far From Home ended.
Here's the real blockbuster. Brace yourselves, you might want to sit out.
Spider-Man's real name is... Spider-Man's name is Peter Parker!
That's right, Spider-Man's identity is revealed as Peter Parker, and he's framed for murder, with no Avengers around to bail him out. And I think Spider-Man really needs this. He needs consequences to his actions. He needs the whole city against him sometimes. He needs to be on the run, or at very least stuck in a very complex situation like this. If they build up to all of this, and then he just decides to dip into the Spider-Verse, it would feel off. The perfect way this movie needs to go is to have Spider-Man constantly being hunted down. He needs to be resourceful, he needs to be on his toes, and he needs to juggle more than one crisis at a time. We need that payoff. Peter needs to somehow get his identity back under wraps or face the consequences of being out in the open while also trying to clear his name for murder. And then, when he finally does all of those things and beats the big bad, whether that's Electro or Scorpion or the whole freaking Sinister Six, he needs to smile. He needs to rest. Peter Parker wins. He overcomes every obstacle no matter what. And then, we need the next big reveal. In Homecoming, the big reveal was this. And Far From Home's end credit scene ended like this.
Spider-Man's name is Peter Parker. What the
And Spider-Man 3, or whatever they end up calling it, could end like this. I told you, I am not an animator. That was the best I could do to represent my concept for the end of the movie or the end credit scene. And that's all my opinions on the Spider-Man 3 movie so far. I really think it would benefit from not being a Spider-Verse movie. I feel like it should build up to it, maybe set it up for Spider-Man 4 or live-action Spider-Verse, whatever you want to call it. But it shouldn't be this movie. Okay, so it's really difficult to make these kinds of videos because news is just constantly coming out about these movies. And for example, while I was filming this, apparently, it was announced that Doctor Strange will be cast for Spider-Man 3, so do with that what you will. Is he going to be the key to the Spider-Verse? Is he just there to be an Avenger to bail Peter out now that Tony's gone? I don't know.